In the beginning, you promised us we can do it. We assented and gave you our mandate. Now, you are doing it.
This tour by this committee has actually showcased the deplorable nature of our rules, especially when they came to Imo State, that my state, Imo, supposed to be declared state of emergency on the roads.
Representing us firmly and fearlessly.
My house was besieged by my constituents who feel so concerned and worried about this gruesome murder. I feel so pain. The people of my constituents are so pain. The worst thing that could happen to a man is to kill your wife right before your friends. The Igbos are the most people who are more liberalized people because we believe in one Nigeria. We live in every part of this country. And I feel bad the way we are being treated. One of my constituents too, Gideon Akaloka, was killed this way. Mr. President, we're asking that this is a woman that has lived in Kano for 40 years, almost all her life. And she's 75 years.
Today, we are happy and fulfilled. We took the right decision.
I believe that we have a lot of responsibility to ensure that the youth of this country have a feel of this governance.
Imo East Senatorial Zone is being actively represented, and our hearts yearn to see you.
Where I come from in the Southeast, Imo State, our people are predominantly teachers. Today, teachers are the most neglected aspect of civil servants.
We gladly welcome you home, our dear illustrious son.
This position you are, you must have two addresses. The address where you are now as a elected person, and the address where you will fall back when you leave.
Distinguished Senator Samuel Nnaemeka Anyanwu, Sam Daddy, your people of Owerri Zone love you. And we, your kingsmen in Ikeduru, love you more.
Well, what is paramount is that people came out under the sun and under the rain to vote for us. And that what we owe them is dividend of democracy. If we do that, Mr. President, we'll be welcome back home.
Welcome home.